Hey everybody, this is Cole James. I hope you're having a great day. I have a really good story for you today. This happened, well, it started a couple of weeks ago. So basically, I got an email from an editor, a book editor, and this person said that she has a client who is writing a book on grief, and can I send you a copy? And if you like the book, would you write something that we could put on the, you know, the back cover of the book, like a quote endorsing it or, you know, saying you liked it? And I said, I get these quite a bit, you know, so I said, well, yeah, send me the book and I'll take a look. And if there's something that I can write, I'll do it. And she said, okay, great. My author is finishing up the book. So several weeks go by and finally I get a PDF copy of the book. I'm not going to name the book in this video, but essentially I open the PDF and I scan through this pre-release copy of this book. It's, you know, several hundred pages long. And as I'm scanning through it, I'm looking at chapters, and then I go to, you know, the citations at the back, and there are many citations in the back, right? So this book contains references to, I would guess, over 100 books at least. So I was just curious. I thought, okay, I wonder when they reference the Grief Recovery Handbook, right? The Grief Recovery Handbook is in 22 languages. It's been around for over 40 years, well over a million copies sold all over the planet. It is regarded as a very approachable, basic way to actually help people with their grief. So I searched for the Grief Recovery Handbook. There's zero results. I'm kind of surprised. I searched for When Children Grieve. That's our book that was designed for parents to help children. There's zero references to that book. Oh, there must be a mistake at this point, I'm thinking, as I search. I searched John W. James. I searched Russell Friedman, you know, the authors of the book. John W. James happens to be my father, too. So a little bit of concern now that this whole book written about grief that cites every book I've ever heard of about grief very conveniently does not mention us at all, not one time. And I'm confused because, again, I was emailed to review the book and kind of give a quote. So I'm really scratching my head at this point. And then I start looking at the different books that are cited in this book. And kind of, you know, I at first, honestly, I thought I was being trolled. You know, I was like, is this a joke? You would ask me for a quote. You would create a book that cited everyone. And let me just say also, the email from the editor initially was very complimentary. The Grief Recovery Method, we love your dad's work. So it was very, so I should probably started there. The email initially was very complimentary. So you can imagine my shock when I actually get a pre-release of this book and everyone in the grief world is cited but my father, but Russell Friedman, but the work that has helped change the lives of millions of people. I'll also say that I would say roughly, conservatively, 95% of the books on grief that are cited in this book did not exist when my dad created the Grief Recovery Method, when my dad created the Grief Recovery Institute. There was virtually nothing out there for people around grief and tragedy when my dad came in and said, I want to specifically help grievers because I'm a griever and there's nothing out here for me. I would say the only other book really available, not the only, but the major book available back then was Elizabeth Kubler-Ross, The Five Stages of Death and Dying, not The Five Stages of Grief. That's a whole nother story we don't have time for in this video. But anyway, you can imagine my shock. And again, my feelings of, am I being trolled here? Is a prank being pulled on me? I didn't quite get it. And then I thought about it more. And here's the deal. A lot of people like to write books to appear really smart. And they like to impress academic type people. And they like to cite each other and they like to show off their keen intellect and how smart they are. Unfortunately, a lot of the times books that are written like that confuse the average person like myself. And when I need to know what to do with sad emotions from the pain, that's not a feature. That's not a good thing, right? That is a problem. So I'm going to chalk this book up, which I won't mention, to another book in a long line of books that are overly intellectual, that are overly confusing, that are really designed to show off how smart the author is, and to kind of just have very high-level overviews on the topic of grief. And then it all made sense why we're never welcome at the table of all these, I would say, gatekeepers of grief. these intellectuals that want to talk about how smart they are and how complex grief is and how you really need these 47 books that we all cite each other on to move forward from your grief. Now it made sense why the grief recovery method is always conveniently left out of the conversation when it comes to the grief world. And again, if you're a griever right now and you're just searching for help, I'm sorry that you even have to see a video about kind of the inside baseball, but the reason I'm making this video is because you have a couple of choices when you decide who you want to work with when it comes to healing your heart. Option one is you're going to find really complex intellectual books that have theories, that have platitudes, that are very surface level, and they kind of browse the surface of grief, and you kind of think this person knows what they're talking about. But when you look a little further, what you'll see in these books is there's no type of plan for you. There's no type of roadmap that would be accessible to you using simple feeling words that keep it focused on the task at hand, which is identifying what is painful for you, the things that you're stuck on, the memories that you keep reliving, the things you're hurt on, how to identify those and how to process those so we don't carry them on for the rest of our lives. That's what you will not find in those type of books. And that is what you will find with the grief recovery method and the grief recovery handbook. So when you're looking at stuff, I really want you to think about who was the audience that was intended by this book. Is it me in the trenches of my grief? Or is it other people at colleges and people with PhDs, and they want to kind of signal to each other that they're really smart and they really understand the topic of grief? I don't want you to waste years and years and years up here trying to fully understand the experience of grief. You already know what grief is here. You need a roadmap in which you can work from here. And I'm sick and tired of being left out of the conversation intentionally by all of these other people that claim to be experts at grief. So future reference is, if you have a book and you mention everyone in the grief world but us, I'm not going to endorse your book. In fact, the only people I endorse with your grief is us, is the grief recovery method and the thousands of people that got certified to do the grief recovery method to help you. We have a simple book, we have a simple system, and our hearts are big, and we know what we're doing and how to help you. And we know how to help you achieve emotional completion with what was unfinished. I know it sounds really simple, and when you're in it, it's not that simple, but it's far from complex, which is what all these other books will leave you with when you read them. When you read them, you'll have a lot of theories, you'll have a lot of intellectually accurate statements, and you will not have a roadmap on what to do with it internally. I do not want that for you. I've seen far too many people change their lives with these tools that we offer. Our book is written at a sixth grade reading level. Not that we think everyone who grieves is reading at a sixth grade reading level. It's because we understand when we have grief, we have a reduced ability to concentrate. We have a lack of energy. Things are confusing when we are in our grief. We did not try to impress academia with these books, nor will we ever. We're not here for colleges and for professors and for intellectuals, frankly. We're here for people, normal people, that have emotion and heartbreak from the past and they don't know what to do with it. If you want to leave us out of the conversation so you can all gatekeep this other form of complexity and make it all really confusing and really hard to do, but offer no real solutions, if you want to keep us out of that conversation, that's fine. I'm not doing this video for you. I'm doing the video for the person that is sick and tired of feeling sick and tired, for the person that is tired of hurting over emotions from the past. Look into what we do. Give us stuff a try. But I just need you to know that there are two camps out there for grief. There's the camp of the intellectuals who want to just make it way complicated and heady. There are people like us that actually want to help you with your grief in a practical, realistic, effective way. And then there are the camp of people that are no farther along following their loss than they were 5 years ago when their loss occurred. And they want you in their camp too. And their camp supports pain, and a reoccurring record player spinning over and over and over, and they will tell you things like, this is your new normal, your life will never be the same no matter what, get used to pain, let me put my arm around you because I have pain, and then we're gonna all get connected with our pain, and our identity very shortly from here to the rest of our lives is I'm the guy with that loss. I'm the guy that lost that person. I'm not trying to be insensitive here, but I want you to move past that identity to the identity that you have, whatever that may be, whatever you may want that to be in the future, I want you to be wherever you want to be. I don't want your identity forever to be, I'm shared in the pain with all these people, and now my story not only includes grief, it revolves around grief. I do not want that for you. And I can't sit here in good conscience, keep my mouth shut, when other people write books and attract attention and band together and pool their resources to get people simply confused about the topic, offering no pragmatic approach. And I cannot sit by and watch as I see all these other big, large programs attract people around the pain, around grief, and because they have nothing else to offer, they just offer them comfort with the pain and the thing we share. And the goal here is to just get really good at comfortable talking about pain because we have nothing else to offer you. I don't want to be that either. Again, if you're watching this and you're looking at your grief, you know, a whole nother side video is how the word trauma has now kind of like taken over everything. A lot of what you're dealing with is grief. Just people will call it trauma. So I'm going to keep it even more simple and say, if you have emotional events that occurred in the past, if you've lost people that you loved in the past, if you've lost people that you didn't love in the past, if people from the past were lousy to you, if you have any sort of hurt from your heart in the past, you should give this work a look. But please don't just jump into a camp where the leader is basically just all about pain. Please don't go into the camp where the leader is all about high-level intellectual complex words and, oh my, this is so complex, and let me just give you platitudes that make you feel better for 4 seconds and they kind of sound good, but really when I look any deeper, there's no plan for me at all. Don't go to those camps. Look into the grief recovery method. We've been doing this now for 50 years. Hundreds of thousands of people have gone through this method. We have the book in 22 languages. It's open to all cultures. It's open to all religions. It's open to men and women of all different walks of life working on all different emotional pain from the past. Give this a shot before you try any of these other programs that specifically don't mention us, that specifically exclude us in the conversation, that explicitly don't cite us in any of their works, even though they then ask us to give reviews on their work. I'm tired of it. I don't want you to spin your wheels. I don't want you to, at best, just waste your time and hurt for long. At worst, find connection among others in pain and then think that's really where I need to be for the rest of my life. And that's my only option is pain and the identity of I'm now a griever forever. I don't want that for you. So I'm making this video. Thank you.